everyone, it's your friend Think Noodles, and welcome to Ask Think episode number 170 for Monday, June 29th, 2015. It is almost July, guys, which means it's almost July 4th here in the U.S. It's almost my wife starting her new job. It's almost Minecon over the weekend. There's a ton of stuff happening this week. Kind of insane, but let's get to last week's question. And I asked you guys, if you were invited to an episode of ThinkSlab, what mod would you choose and why? And the first answer comes to us from APT4 or GamerAPT4. And it says, if I was in ThinkSlab, I'd pick the ThinkSlab mod because you can't have ThinkSlab without the ThinkSlab mod. And that's actually, that's true. You really can't. You wouldn't have Kevin or Dave or Noodle Soup or anything like that. Kraz Goot says, or spawn, because I could spawn Mobzilla in Thing's face and scare him. And actually, a lot of the answers revolved around destruction and kind of annoying and scaring me, so that's that's nice of you guys. X Owl Lover X says, if I was in ThinkSlab, I would want the Nyan Cat mod, because how cool would it be to fly around on the Nyan Cat and have rainbows farting out of her, assuming Nyan Cat is a girl, also because she's so adorable. And yeah, you know, I guess the Nyan Cat really isn't a boy or a girl, you can't really tell. But rainbows out the butt, for some reason that makes me think girl rather than boy. Awesome Sauce says, if I could choose any mod for Ask Think, I would choose Minecraft Comes Alive mod, because the villagers look like people. I would also add in the Lucky Blocks mod, just because I like it. And that's actually a really good idea, because it would give, when you're playing and you're in a ThinkSlab mod, ThinkSlab video, the villagers wouldn't be just, you know, boring old villagers. They would actually have some variety. Carla Canessa says, if I could come with you on a ThinkSlab, I would want to use the My Little Pony mod, which is My Little Pony because I love this show. So technically, I'm a Pega sister, which is like a brony, but in girl version. Don't judge me because I'm almost 13. I'm not judging you. There are boys much older than you that like My Little Pony as well. So nothing to be ashamed of there. Mint Muffin LPS says, the tornado mod. Even though you did that one before, it would still be so cool because you can go flying on it and it destroys everything. Noodle on. It is cool and you can go flying on it, but not when you're not in creative, because it ends up dropping you on the ground and you die pretty fast with that. Crazy Fingers JG says, the Sleep Well mod. If you don't know what that mod is, I'll tell you. If you do, never mind. Anyway, because I don't know. The Sleep Well mod is a mod with two beds. The blue bed contains good dreams. The gray bed contains nightmares. To make a blue bed, get one red bed, 10 blue hope mushrooms. And to make a gray bed, get a red bed and 10 gray mushrooms. Oh, and by the way, Dan did that mod. And you should use the two beds to prank Kevin and Dave. Give Dave the blue bed, give Kevin the gray bed. Don't tell them, they give you dreams. Surprise! And this was great. And this was another thing that I noticed with a lot of them. It was, you gave me the mod that you would use and also a ThinkSlab plot suggestion. So that was an added bonus. And I like that one that you just gave me there. That was pretty awesome. Purple Cupcake 111 says, the mod I would choose would probably be the Blocking Dead mod, because I love The Walking Dead. And I've not used the Blocking Dead mod, but I love Walking Dead too. Quinn Parzik says, if I were to be in an episode of ThinkSlab, I would have to choose the mod of aquaculture. Mostly because it's based around fishing, and I love fishing. And new foods, new kinds of fish, and how much they weigh, and the ever so not tasty whale burger that fills your hunger all the way up to full. And that's awesome, because I like fishing too, but in real life, fishing in Minecraft is boring enough that I built, you know, the automatic fishing machine in the Noodle Planet so I wouldn't have to waste time doing it. Julia from Curly Nice says, if I was on an episode of ThinkSlab, I would choose the, well, I don't know, because there's no mod that I know of that will allow me to slingshot something into food, because I love launching food. Mr. Stud says, the dinosaur mod, because I've recently watched Jurassic World, and me and Think can go to Jurassic World and we can run from the dinosaurs. Actually, that should be an episode, but replace me with Kevin and Dave. Anyways, noodle on. creepy, silent otaku says, if I were invited to Think Slab, we'd probably be playing around with Rainbow Lucky blocks. Don't worry, they'll be super lucky. It'll be fun playing with the stuff we get. Evilly laughs. What? You didn't hear that? And then I love the comment after. Ba-da-da! Raymond Broussard says, if Think Noodles invited me to Think's Lab, the mod we would do is the Lego mod because I really love Lego. And I do too. You know, that Lego mod, I've been watching forever to see if it ever comes to 1.7 or even 1.8. But they just haven't updated it. Winnalee says, if I rent Think Slab, I would probably want to do the My People Clonecraft mod so I can make a giant army of me's and Kevin's and then blow up your world with the Too Much TNT mod. Kaboom! Alex V says, if I was in Think Slab, I would pick the Mo Chickens mod because I would like to see Kevin taking advantage of experimenting on chickens. And I don't know if I want to see that after he did that to the Squicken. Logan Kerr says, to answer this week's question, if Think invited me to Think Slab, I would choose the Transformers mod. If there is one, because let's be honest, Transformers and Think Slab would be pretty sweet. Also, just picture Megatron trying to destroy the lab, and it was me thinking the minions and Kopi's job to defend it. Xtianus 3 says, if I were in a Think Slab episode, I would choose the Lion King mod, because we can complete quests with the Lion King, with the characters, and it's also because you can find Pumbaa and listen to him fart. Alvaro Villarreal says, if I were able to go to Think Slab and put a mod, it would be the dinosaur mod, and we would go to Jurassic World. Noticing a theme here, guys. It's a really popular movie, and I haven't seen it yet. No. And Kevin brings a T-Rex baby to the lab, and the mama comes and wrecks the lab looking for her baby. This sounds like a recommendation. Well, I guess this counts anyways. Noodle on. Eric Cole forces, if I had a chance to go to Think Slab, well, I wouldn't pick a mod. They are too complicated and annoying to download. Plus, Minecraft now has JSON. Therefore, command blocks will take over Think Slab, and soon it will become a Mineplex server with many different color ads. I don't know about that, but, you know, I've tried using command blocks in 1.8 for a few episodes. I mean, I got the Dinnerbone one to work, but, you know, I find that for some reason, the constant clock that's running, to make the command blocks run and change things and things like that. After, I don't know, 20 to 30 minutes of the command block structure being built, it starts to really lag my world and makes it difficult for me to record. Spectre Blaze says, if I was in the Think Slab video, I would choose the Terramine mod because I love Terraria. The story is we find a crate of Terraria loot and Kevin summons the Eye. And I don't know what that is because I don't play Terraria, but that sounds like an awesome episode because the Eye sounds like it's something bad. XXUltraXX151 says, if I was in Think Slab for one day, I would choose the YouTubers mod so I can take a screenshot with all the YouTubers and show my friends the screenshot and act like I met a bunch of YouTubers at Noodle On. And well, for me, I would just go to the Minecraft forums and find a new mod that I'd never used before and play that. Because I really haven't thought of next, because I was thinking that I would know what the next episode of Think Slab was, but I haven't really thought about it yet. So otherwise I would say that's what I would do, and then I would do it, and then yeah, it would be completely true. But truthfully, I am going to go to the Minecraft forums, find a new mod that I've never used, and figure out how to integrate that into the next Think Slab. Now for next week's question, guys, it comes to us from Sir Coffee, and it's next week. What animal was your childhood toy? It doesn't have to be an animal, obviously. It could be a stuffed, I don't know, clown. I don't know why I thought of that. But anyway, what was its name and how did you get it? Which is really, really cool because it tells me a lot about you guys. Now, before we get to the questions for me, I want to remind you to leave your question in the comments below so I can have something to answer next week. Remember, only one question per comment, but you can leave as many comments as you like. And if the comments on this episode of Ask Think are closed, go to the most recent Ask Think and ask your question there. Now, on to the questions. And the first one comes from Navy Phantom. And it says, anybody else hear like a squeak at 422? Because of on the last episode, you guys probably heard the squeaking in the background more than once. And you got it right. It was Kopi chewing on a squeaky toy. She was actually like right next to me and having me pull it back and forth while I was doing the audio for Ask Think, like, and she was squeaking it and I was pulling on it. So yep, you guessed right. Lindsay Rose says, "Dear Think, how much longer do you plan on making Ask Thinks? Because I really love the series, especially the ones with Think's wife in them. And also because you put a lot of effort and time into making these videos. Perfect. Thanks." And of course, Noodle On. So as you guys might realize by the title of the episode, I'm going to make some changes to Ask Think. I'm not going to get rid of it. It's just that I put a lot of time into these episodes. I would say on average about 4 hours into each Ask Think. And that's a lot of time that I could use to record other videos, edits, things like that, or even just, you know, building or anything in my current series. And I'd like to get some of that time back because I've noticed that, you know, on average, on average, an Ask Think video gets between, I think because Stranded Deep is sort of skewing some of it, but you know, on average, it gets about 30,000 views. There's about 900,000 subscribers to my channel. And so 30,000 out of 900,000, we're talking about 3% of my subscribers, of you guys that actually watch Ask Think. That's not a very high number considering the amount of time that I put into it. Even further, of the 30,000 that watch you, it only gets about, I don't know, less than 1,000 likes. So we're talking about now, you know, less than 1% of all my subscribers actually like Ask Think. So that's like 1 in 100. So to me, that tells me that the series isn't that popular. That's okay, because I still enjoy doing it and I still want to do it. However, I'm not going to do it every week from now on because, you know, I think that a lot of people, you know, I feel like if it was less often, more people would tune in and be like, okay, what's this going to be? Because it's sort of more special instead of every single week, a bunch of different questions. And instead, it's going to be once a month. And I'm going to do it the first Monday of every month. So next week, yes, will be, it's going to be the first of the monthly episodes because it will be the first Monday in July. And from then, you know, the next one will be the first Monday of August, the first Monday of September, et cetera. And we'll see how that goes for a month or two and see if maybe I should do it every 2 weeks or something like that. But weekly, I think, is too much for a series that isn't completely popular or it is the least popular series on my channel. And I think I've just sort of saturated you guys with questions and answers about me. Maybe you don't want to know, or maybe you've heard everything you already need to know, or wanted to ever know about me. I'm gonna do it less often, and I want to say up front right now that this is not me like trying to like encourage or like I don't know, make you guys click the like button to try and, you know, get me more likes so that I keep doing the series. I've already made the decision that it really. With my wife and her new job, I think she's going to be working a lot less hours. So that means I don't have as much time to do what I do because we're going to have a real, like, normal life now. I was looking for a way, or just, you know, looking at my channel. I was on vacation. I was like looking at it and I was like, man, you know, Ask Think is really, really not that popular. But I still love doing it. I still love getting answers from you guys and interacting with you guys. So I still want to do it. So I'm, I think I've been talking for 10 minutes now. I want to make it. I'm going to make it once a month for now. And we'll see if we need to make it once every 2 weeks, if it's too far in between, which it may be, but we'll give it a try, guys. And also, I'm trying to think of the right way to field questions for Ask Think, because I know how the comment sections work on YouTube. Been here long enough, been annoyed with it long enough, as you guys have. And I know if I ask you guys to put comments in the questions, or questions in the comments, if I go and look at them a month later, it's going to say it has 2,000 comments. However, there's going to be, 11 in the comment section that I can choose from, and that's not cool. So I'm thinking I do have a subreddit, so I think I may ask the monthly question there, and then also maybe a couple of days before I'm gonna record the Ask Think episode of that month, I'll ask on Twitter as well, so that for you guys to just respond with the hashtag. And then so I'll be fielding questions from Reddit and Twitter. And then, I mean, if there are questions left over in the comments, I'll look at those, of course. But I don't expect there to be many. I think they'll get deleted by YouTube. So bear with me, guys. Probably will get a lot of I probably get a lot of dislikes on that, that I'm dialing back the series. But seeing as not as many of you really watch it that much or react to it, there may not be as many dislikes as I am, expecting. Aaron A. says, what happened to Portals of Mystery? It's still being worked on. I was away for a week, and they had been building the sets, I guess, is what you would call them, for the next episode of Portals of Mystery. And sort of coming up with, not the script, but the basic plot. And then I went away for a week. So I wanted to be involved in all aspects of the episode, so that it got put on hold for about 10 days. We're resuming now, and I think they're starting the recording and filming today. So we could see it maybe by the end of the week, but most likely beginning of next week. Crystal Miner 2364 AJ says, I've recently started a schedule for my channel and I can't seem to keep up. I should upload every day except Wednesdays and Sundays. Any advice how to keep up? It's really hard to keep up. And I'm glad you have put a schedule because that does help. But what I do find is, and it might help you, is to, so let's say it's, so you said every day except Wednesdays and Sundays. So let's say it is Sunday, right? And you know you have a video. You're not uploading today, but you know you have a video for Monday and one for Tuesday. I would say on Sunday, if you can, record Monday and Tuesday's video in advance, or at least just Monday. So on Monday, you can go, oh, geez, can I do Tuesday? Or on Monday, you can record Tuesday and Thursday. Try and stay a day or so ahead, and that should really, really help. Laura the Dork asks, will you be attending Minecon 2015 this weekend? No, I will not be in London this weekend. It just was not possible. We expected to be moving, but we haven't yet. But we were supposed to be moving just before vacation, and well, now still moving in, but we actually didn't. My wife starts a new job on Wednesday. My parents are in town. And I just got back from vacation. There's just no way that that I could have made it. SlowMojo9 says, I don't understand why you don't put face cam on any of your videos. Why not? I've explained this before, but it's been a while. So the reason I don't do it is because, well, one, to me, especially for Minecraft videos, I don't think that my reaction, maybe I make really funny faces. Now that I think about it, I probably do. Because I always say, face cam reactions don't really add a lot to the video. And that's a personal thing. Like when I'm watching a video, I really don't look at the face cam if someone has it. I just don't. And I know that that's a personal thing and a lot of you guys do, but I don't. The other reason is that people have an idea of what I look like. More so that I'm a character inside Minecraft or whatever I'm playing. And I've done a face cam reveal, one video, but I don't want to put my face cam on it because people have an idea of what I look like or what they, some people, I would imagine a lot of people imagine me as the character, as my skin in Minecraft. And I like that. And I don't want to ruin people's imagination of what I look like if they don't want to know. And for those who don't want to know, if I put a face cam on the videos, any set of videos I put it on, they won't watch it because like, oh, I don't want to know because it'll ruin my perception or imagination or whatever. So I just don't do that because I like them to think of me as the character. Luca Berry, Minecraft Amore, says, how come everyone uploads at around 11 PST? So I upload, let's see, PST, I upload it at around 12:30 PST. And the reason for that is it's a decent time because it's 3:30 where I live in New York, so most kids are starting to get home or have just gotten home. And then it's around 8:30 at night in the UK, so it's not too late for them to watch my videos, but I would imagine that the people publishing around 11 a.m. PST are from the UK, which puts it around 5-ish? No. 11, that's 2. So that's 7 p.m. British time. Joseph Nwosibi says, are there other ways to get a golden noodle reward besides drawing? Because most of my friends are not good at drawing. Well, I'm terrible at drawing. but yeah, of course, I don't know if you have watched some of the recent episodes of the Noodle Planet, but I've given away golden noodle awards for just suggestions for the Noodle Planet, especially now that I'm building the Noodletopia. People are coming up with some amazing suggestions and builds in Minecraft that I really want to feature and show. Sedimist asks, does Kobe ever beg for food? Or did you train her not to as a little puppy? Well, so I did train her not to as a little puppy, but over the past 8 years or so, Fink's wife has taught her to beg. Well, not really. Like, what she does is she doesn't actually beg, but she like lays down at your feet. And the reason for that is because she knows that every time we eat, my wife saves a little bit of whatever we're eating, just a tiny bite, so that when we're done eating, Kopi gets a little bite. And so she waits around for it. Carson Decker asks, why don't you do Things Lab episodes more often? Whenever you finish an episode, you get us to hope that another one is nearer than or with any other series. Well, they take a long time for me to plan out, record, and edit. And honestly, I have a hard time even twice a week. Really, really does consume a lot of my time. And more than that, it just would not be possible. I probably, if I did it 3 or 4 times a week, I couldn't have any other videos on my channel other than those. I don't want to do that. Miancat is Bob Tart says, hey, Vink, do you like Approaching Nirvana? You use Sugar High as your outro, Cancun for Pop Tropical walkthroughs, and Love Theory for time-lapse. Well, I use them because they have a really, really great licensing agreement, or I guess it's a licensing agreement, so that I can put them on my videos so you guys can enjoy some music, and they don't get claimed by them and other record companies. Abby Studios asks, wait, so you have Windows and OS X. Do you record on Windows for Lego World with something like Fraps or DXtree and then switch back over to OS X for editing, or do you use Windows full time and edit with Vegas or Premiere? So yeah, I have both Windows and OS X on my computer, and I do record Lego Worlds I don't even use a recording software for it. I mean, technically, I do have an NVIDIA 780M, which allows me to record with this built-in software called Shadowplay. It's built into the video card for free. Works really well. It does it at 60 frames per second. And then I use Audacity to capture my audio, which is also a free program for Windows. So if you guys have NVIDIA cards, check out Shadowplay. It works really well. And again, it's free, and Audacity is free. And once I'm done recording, I have my RAID hard drive array. It's accessible on Windows, so I just copy over the recording, the video and the voice, or I guess the gameplay and the voice, and then I boot straight to OS X and start editing. Asma Irfan asks, what kind of school did you go to in Indonesia? Was it a public school? No, I went to an international school, which would be classified, I guess, as a private school. The public schools in Indonesia would all have been taught in Bahasa Indonesia, which is the language that they speak there. And, I spoke it well by the time I left, but obviously when I first went, I didn't speak a single word of it. So if I was put into public school there, I would have totally failed. Super Sunny Boy 12 asks, have you ever used Linux before? Yes, I have. Not in a long time, so it's probably changed a lot. But I remember I set up a Linux server for my parents when, this is a long time ago, but when I was in university or college, and they needed basically a router. And routers were, I don't know why we didn't, I'm not really sure why we didn't, maybe we didn't get them, or they were expensive at the time. Now you can buy them, you know, free with rebate or whatever. But yeah, my dad had an extra computer with, and I stuck two network cards into it and had like an internal network and an external network to their cable modem or whatever it was at the time for their broadband connection. Although it wasn't very fast, so maybe it wasn't even broadband, but whatever. I set up a Linux server that once set up, it was headless. We took the monitor off and it just sat there and ran and routed all of the internal computers onto the internet. Love Music 99 asks, is there another way to look at Just Think Slime on your channel now that you took away the playlist on your main page? You know, I've been seeing a lot of that. And I think I've mentioned it before in previous Ask Thinks. So I've gone ahead and put it back because it seems to be just kind of an issue. I just think that that you guys really, I think what people did was not necessarily looking at the videos themselves, like the in order episode 1, 2, 3. I think that a lot of people would click the ThinkSlab playlist link and then scroll down to the bottom or scroll through it to find episodes they wanted to see. So I put it back. Lucky Ducky says, think when you stretch, do you make noises when you stretch? And Noi counting, yawning, and why? I think I, hold on. Yep, I do. Yeah, I knew I did, but I couldn't think of the noise that I made. So just stretched my shoulders and there you go. The next couple of people ask what software I use, what mic I use, things like that. And you don't have to look through Ask Think to find it. If you go to thinknoodles.me, my website, which is linked on my channel page, you can find the answers there. But real quick, video editing software is Final Cut Pro X, and the microphone I use is an MXL USB 009. PSearcher08 asks, I have an old iMac G4, I think. Do you know how to upgrade it? Unfortunately, iMacs are pretty much laptops with an external mouse and screen and keyboard. They are not really upgradable other than the RAM that's in them, just like a laptop would be. So the only way to really upgrade it is to buy a new one. Grace Sosie asks, do you check your email for fan art? Yes, of course, all the time. I check my email every day. I don't always respond, and I'm sorry about that. I just get so many emails each day that I can't respond, but I always check. MasterNick3 says, hey, Vink, do you recommend buying Lego World? I have enough money, but it's only in early access, and I Googled it. People say there's bugs. Also, not sure if the price will go up or down when the full game is released. If you like what you see on YouTube and seeing people play it, then definitely buy it. It is only in early access, and yes, there are bugs right now, but the great thing is, if you buy it now, when there's updates, you get them for free. Any content updates, you get those for free as well. So bugs now is not a big deal because the software is constantly being updated. So when there are updates to correct the bugs, you still get those. As far as the price, I would imagine, because this is typical, when something's in early access, that's about the cheapest it's going to be. As it gets closer and closer to release, it'll get more expensive. So if you want it, I'd say buy it now. Sam Wexler asks, are you going to do something special for Clash of Clans episode 50? I hadn't thought of it, but I don't really know, like, what would I do to make it special? If you guys have suggestions, please let me know. Karma Sab says, I think I want to join your clan, but I only have 217 trophies. Is there a way to get trophies easy without losing them? Well, I mean, you're always going to lose trophies. Everybody loses trophies. But the best way to get trophies easily is to attack. You don't want to rely on winning defenses to get trophies. I mean, it happens, but a lot of the time you're going to want to attack other people. And I would say if you really just want to get trophies, and not something I recommend, I don't know what your town hall level is. If you're at a decent town hall level, then you could do that. But what you want to do is look for exposed town halls and then just snipe the town halls that are far away, and you can pick up some trophies that way. Shadow King asks, what do you think of the Clash of Clans update coming soon? It includes a new coat of paint for the graphics, level 5 dragons, 2 leagues above champions, Titan and Legend, and a dark spell factory with a new spell called the Poison Spell. So I've heard rumors about it, and I heard less things than what you said, or actually different things than what you said. I'm not sure where everybody's getting their information, but hey, I'm pretty excited about it. It's been a while since we've had an update, so if they're planning something this big, that's awesome. SuperRohan23CP asks, do you play Roblox? I right before I left for vacation, I was going to play it for Fan Choice Friday, but I had this problem where the mouse pointer was stuck on my screen, but it wasn't following my actual mouse. And it was really annoying to try and record like that because I had 2 mice on the screen, and I could have hidden one after the recording so you guys wouldn't see it, but I could see it. I couldn't stand it. yeah, eventually I will for a Fan Choice Friday. The next couple of people ask how I talk to people at Freddy's and Dumbledore and things like that. That is part of the custom NPCs mod. There's built-in dialogues, and the Harry Potter one, I can't believe how much dialogue I wrote for that. There were so many, but yeah, that's how you do it. HG Yeager asks, are you going to quit Pixelmon? Because I watched one of James's Pixelmon videos, and he said that you, Dan, and him were thinking about quitting Pixelmon and doing a different series together. Well, not necessarily quitting, but we've toyed with the idea of ending the series, sort of moving on and doing a new series together, modded something on a server, in the similar, I guess, style, but not Pixelmon. And the reason for that is because we're having trouble with upgrading the server again, we feel like, you know, it might be about time to move on to try something new, something to excite you guys. So we haven't yet. We're taking suggestions. We haven't decided to do that yet or even soon, but it's on the table. XXCatastical. XX says, think in your free time, do you play on your crazy craft world if you kept it? I definitely kept it in the exact same form. Well, I'm trying to think. I think I gave you guys level episode 50 download. I'm not sure if I gave it to you the end download, but yeah, it is in the exact same state as the end of the last episode, and of course I kept it. Caitlin Manning asks, hey, think soft or hard cookies? Also, I want to hug you. Well, that's cute. Big hug, but I would have to say it depends on the cookie, but I'm thinking right now in my head, chocolate chip cookie, which definitely needs to be soft and warm and chewy. All right, guys, that's it for this episode of Ask Think. Don't forget to leave your question in the comments below so I can have something to answer next week for the monthly Ask Think, if that makes sense. Also, if the comments on this Ask Think are closed, go to the next Ask Think and ask your question there. Otherwise, check Reddit or on Twitter. Right. I gotta perfect that. That's gonna be tough. I'll see you guys again soon. Thanks for watching. And of course, new line.